In this video, we're going to run our application and we're going to try the password reset request and see if the email message is successfully sent. And I will add a few breakpoints before I run this application. The very first breakpoint I will add to my REST controller to the reset password request method. So I will add it right here to see what would be the result of my function. And another breakpoint I would add somewhere inside of the service layer. So I will go there and open the implementation of this function. Let's put a breakpoint here to see if we were able to successfully find user with the provided email address. And let's put a breakpoint here. And let's go now inside of the send password reset request function. I'll open its implementation and maybe add a breakpoint right here. Having breakpoint here, we will be able to inspect everything that's above. We'll be able to have a look at the message body, at the email address, and finally we can step over the line and see if the result is not null and if we get the message ID and when the return value is set to true. Okay, so now let's debug this application. Okay, it's now up and running. I will go to the user controller and we'll double check the password reset request URL. So this is the URL that we should use to be able to successfully send the request to this web service endpoint. I'll now bring up my Postman and I'll paste the URL here. So that's going to be HTTP post request to, at this moment, localhost 8080, then web application context path, users, and the password reset request is our mapping for this request. And then it should have the body, and the body is in JSON format. And for that, we need to set headers. So one of the headers that we want to have is the content type, application JSON, and we can set the accept header to specify in what format do we want web servers to respond back to us. I will also choose application JSON. So we're sending application JSON and we're getting back application JSON. Now I'll go back to body, and the single value inside of my JSON payload here is email address. And I need to provide email address here that first exists in my database. This user needs to exist. If I provide incorrect email address, our functionality will not work because this user does not exist. We cannot let them reset their password because they don't exist. And if they do exist, the email address should be correct, not test@test.com, because I need to be able to go into that email inbox and check email and see if Amazon Simple Email Service was able to successfully deliver an email with the link. Okay, so, and let's double check the request body of our method. If I click on the password reset request model, it should have a single filled email, which is correct. Our JSON payload will be converted into this password reset request model, and email class field will be set to this value. Okay, so everything looks like to be correct. Let's just send this request and see how it works. Yes. Okay, we're now inside of the request reset. We're still in the REST controller. Let's step one line over. And we now inside of the service layer function, let's check the value of email address. The value is correct. So everything is good here. Let's step over and see if we were able to find this record in our database. Okay, let's check the user entity. User entity is not null. I see that it does have email address here and some of the other fields. So looks like good. Let's step over one more line. It's not null. We have passed this. So now we're about to generate password reset token. Let's step over this line and check the value of the token. So let's step over this. Let's save this entity. Okay, and we are now about to send email message to this user, and the user is going to be email address is equal to Sergey Kargapolov at swiftdeveloperblog.com. So let's resume debugging. Okay, so we are now inside of Amazon Simple Email Service class. The from email address is sergeykargapulov@swiftdeveloperblog.com. This is email address I have whitelisted. The subject, password reset, that's correct. We have body with the token. That body contains HTML. And see, it says, hi, Sergey. So the first name was successfully replaced. The first name we receive as a method argument, the email address, and the token we receive as method arguments. And so far, everything looks like is working. The message does contain first name. Let's check if the message contains a link with the token. So if I'll scroll a little bit, and I see HTML link here, and it does contain token as HTTP request parameter attached to the URL query string. Okay, so everything looks like working. Let's just continue and see if this email is successfully sent. I will step over one line. Now, email message should be sent. I'll step over one line and result is not null. And there is a message ID in that result. So everything should be good. Let's just resume debugging. Let's now switch to a postman and scroll down to see the response. So operation result is success, and the operation name is request password reset is also set, status 200, so it's working. Let me now go into my email client and check if I have received that email message. Okay, so here's my email client. I have just logged in, and I'll go back. So this is the password reset request, which I have just received, 7:45 a.m. I'll open it, and here's a link, so I can click on this link, and it will attempt to open the verification service project and the password reset HTML, which we don't currently have. But what's important at this moment is that the token value is here, and the JavaScript that we are going to add to our password reset HTML page can read it. So let's continue and update our verification service project and create this password reset HTML page.